गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। ऑडियो एंड वीडियो आर ओके। या गुड आफ्टरनून मोनिश्वर। बोथ ऑडियो एंड वीडियो आर ओके। आर यू हियर माय वॉइस? पीसीवी इज विजिबल। गुड आफ्टरनून मा अभिनया। या थैंक यू। Right, so look at that. So we have a every Saturday we have a maths test. Okay, online test. Okay, 20 to 30 MCQs. Right, time 1 hour. Okay, and portion is coming Saturday. Portion is chapter 1 fully. Sets. Okay, so in sets, some portions are deleted. That means difference of two sets, complement of a set, and their property. These two are deleted. Deleted portions are deleted only. We never include in any of the test. Okay, either in the weekly test or a midterm test. Okay, in any of the tests, we never include the deleted portions. Okay, so the time may be 10 to 11 or 11 to 12. Okay, I will inform the time later. Okay, I will inform you the time later, but these are the confirmed one. Every Saturday we have a test, 20 to 30 MCQs, 1 hour. And coming Saturday, the portion is chapter 1. Okay, and there is a negative mark also. Okay, so there must be a negative mark. If you are answering wrongly, so you have a negative marks. So be serious and study the chapter thoroughly, work out the problems, try to understand the concepts. Okay, the questions mostly outside the NCERT only. NCERT based, but outside the NCERT. Because I am giving the same NCERT question, means so many are just copying that and answering the questions, okay, from the book. So therefore, I am going to ask some outside the NCERT questions only. Okay, if you are not taking seriously, if you are not attending the test, okay, if you are getting some poor marks, means everything will be viewed seriously. So that marks will be sent to your parent and you and your school also. Okay, so be serious about the test, right? So study the chapter. We have enough time. Yeah, full chapter. It will be little bit tough, but NCERT model only. Okay. That is outside the NCERT, it will be tough for you. If you are not studying anything, means it is tough for you. If you are studying everything, means it is easy for you. That's all. Okay. Right. So be serious and I will confirm the time. So we have enough time. 1 week time is there. You try to complete the chapter. The chapter is very simple chapter. Okay. Right, so now come to that. Only one chapter. Coming Saturday, I don't know the date exactly. You please, Kumaran, you please go through the first chapter. The first chapter is very simple one only. Sets, how to represent the sets, okay. What are the operations on sets? A union B, A intersection B, operation on sets. Okay, but A minus B is deleted, complement is deleted only, A union B, A intersection B only. Right? Some properties. Some properties also there. You please go through that. Okay? If you have any doubt, you please ask me. I will explain, I will clarify your doubts. Okay? 22 deleted portions, deleted only, I never include in our NCERT based test. Okay. In maths, we never include the deleted portions, but in NEET, some NCERT portions deleted, but in NEET syllabus, that portions are there. So you have to study that. Okay. Yeah, today you will get the homework. You are the batch one, 11th batch one. I will give the homework. Okay. Yes, in NEET, no max, only physics, chemistry, biology. Harish, in NEET, you have to concentrate only physics, chemistry, biology. And max, you have to concentrate only for board, CBSE board. Okay. Right. Now come to that. Next topic is we are going to discuss the modulus and the conjugate of a complex number. Modulus and conjugate. Of a complex number. Okay, so let Z is equal to A plus IB be a complex number. A plus IB be a complex number. Okay, so then the modulus of Z is defined by modulus of Z. What is modulus of Z, sir? This is my next topic. Okay, suppose I am taking as this is X, this is Y. Okay, so this is my real axis. This is my imaginary axis. Okay. This is my real axis. This is my imaginary axis. Imaginary axis means I am going to take it as an imaginary value. This is called as imaginary value. This is called as real value. So these real values are going to take it as in this x-axis. These imaginary values are going to take it as in my y-axis. Suppose, okay, this is a complex number means this is a complex number. Is that okay? So this is nothing but. My complex number is nothing but A comma B. So that means here this distance is A. Okay, and this distance is B. Okay, so this is A, this is B, right? So in a plane, we can represent the complex number is that if your complex number is A plus IB, this is the real part. Your real part is representing in x-axis. Your imaginary part representing in y-axis, okay, and make a point. This number is called as my complex number. My Z is, my complex number is, this is A comma B is representing this, okay, right. So, what is the distance between this origin and this complex number? The distance between origin and this complex number. This is called as your modulus of Z. Are you okay? Any complex number can be represented in a plane X and Y axis. My X axis considered as a real axis. That means consider the real part of Z numbers. Y axis considers the imaginary part of the real numbers. Imaginary part of that complex number. Okay. So therefore, my complex number, any complex number can be written as, can be represented as Z is A comma B, right? And the distance between origin and the Z, the complex number, this distance is denoted as modulus of Z, okay? This distance from the origin to the complex number is denoted as modulus of Z. How to find out? How to find out the length between this origin and the complex number Z? So the modulus of Z is defined by, my modulus of Z is nothing but root over this real part square plus imaginary part square. Imaginary part means b only. Okay, so any part is having I, that part is called as imaginary part. This b is the imaginary part, a is real part. There is no I here. No I mean this is real part. Here I is there mean this is called as my imaginary part. Take a square of real part and imaginary part, take the sum and take the square root, that is my modulus of Z. So how you are getting, sir? I'm using that Pythagoras theorem, that's all. Okay, so this is my A, this is my B, this is my origin, this is my real complex number is Z. Okay, how to find out this length? This length is nothing but use the Pythagoras theorem. What is Pythagoras theorem? Sum of the squares equal to sum of the squares of the sides is equal to square of the hypotenuse. So therefore, this is root over A square plus B square. This is I'm writing here, modulus of Z is equal to root of A square plus B square. Okay. Right, so therefore this is called as my modulus of a complex number. Modulus is nothing but the distance between the complex number and the origin. From the origin, what is the distance to the complex number? That is my modulus. Okay, and this diagram, this plane is called as organ plane. If you are representing a complex number in a plane, means that plane is called as organ plane. That is our next topic. Okay, right. So the sign should not be in zero. Yeah, I will explain. I power minus 40. I will explain. Don't worry. Last 5 minutes, will you please ask your doubt in last 5 minutes? Okay, will, what is your doubt? The sign should not be in zero. What is that? Sign should not be in zero. Okay, no doubt. You explain this concept once again. Yeah, please. I'm explaining. Don't worry. Yeah, dear students, please look at that. I'm explaining again. Please try to understand. Okay, if some complex number is given, 2 plus 3i. This is my complex number. How to represent this 2 plus 3i complex number in my plane? This is x, this is y. Okay, you 2 take it in your x-axis. Suppose this is my 2. And 3 take it in your z axis. This is 3. Therefore, this is called it as my 2, 3. This is my complex number z. Okay. So this 2 representing the x axis, 3 representing the y axis. This is called it as imaginary axis. This is called it as real axis. Okay, so for real axis, you can take it as one, take only 2. But imaginary axis means, how can I represent the imaginary axis? Multiply by I. So therefore, my complex number is 2 plus 3i can be written as 2, 3 and representing in my plane. Okay, my x distance is 2, y distance is 3. So therefore, this is my complex number. We can represent this complex number in the diagram like this. Okay. And that this is my origin. The distance between origin to this complex number, this is my modulus of Z. Modulus of Z is the length, distance. Modulus of Z is the distance. Distance between okay, so modulus of X is the modulus of Z is the distance between the origin and the complex number. Okay. Are you clear? Right. So therefore, how to define this? How to define this? So this is my 2, this is my 3. Then how to find out this hypotenuse? My hypotenuse is nothing but by Pythagoras theorem, root over 2 square plus 3 square. That is, I am writing here, if my complex number is a plus ib, this is my distance a, this is my distance b, okay? So then the distance between the origin to this complex number z is the modulus z. Modulus z is nothing but root over a square plus root of a square plus b square by Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so the modulus is nothing but the distance between the origin to the complex number. Yes, so if you are representing a complex number in a diagram, you consider this x-axis is the real axis, y-axis is always imaginary axis. Whenever you are considering the real complex number, your y-axis is the imaginary axis, x-axis is the real axis. And this entire diagram, entire plane, this entire plane is called as organ plane. If you are representing complex number in plane, that plane is called as organ plane. This is organ, A-R-G-A-N-D, organ plane. Okay, this entire plane is, when it is an organ plane, if you are representing a complex number in a plane, that plane is called as organ plane. What about my x-axis that are considering the real values, real axis, real values of this complex number. And the y-axis is the imaginary values of considering the imaginary values of the given complex number, on the complex number, okay. Yes, x comma y is a comma b respectively. Yeah, very good, Sneha. Which is organ plane, yes. Chandru, this plane is called as organ plane. How to represent if b is root of some number which is not a perfect square number? Dikshita, what is your question? How to represent if b is a root of some number which is not a perfect number? So look at that. Sir, this is, I'm getting some root 2, sir. Suppose, what is the answer here? What is this modulus of z here? This is root 2 square, 2 square 4, 3 square is 9. So therefore, this is root of 9 plus 4, that is 13. Your root 13 is not a perfect square number. Okay, but I know the value of root 13, that is 3.3 or 3.4, like that. Okay, that is the distance. My 3.3 is the distance, 3.4 is the distance. Okay, it is not necessarily the perfect square number. Yes, yes, whole plane, entire plane is including x-axis, y-axis, including all the complex number. Whenever you are representing a complex number in a plane, then that is called as organ plane. Okay? So if you are not considering this complex number, because here look at that, I am splitting in this 2 plus I, I am splitting into 2 comma 3. Here what is my 3? My 3 is the imaginary value, 2 is the real value. Okay? Right? Yes. Yeah, Dikshita, what you are asking, 2 plus root of minus 13, how to represent? Yeah, I'm representing, good question. 2 plus root of minus 13. Dikshita is asking, sir, how to represent this is 2 plus root of minus 13. So, I'm going to write it as 2 plus I root 13. Okay. So, therefore, this is a number for 2 comma root 13. Right, so therefore this is my distance 2, in x-axis this is 2. In y-axis, y-axis is also real number only. It is the name of this y-axis is imaginary axis. But what is my y? My y is containing all the real numbers only, because I have already told that my z is equal to a plus ib. What is a and b? Both are real numbers only. A and b are real numbers, but some I is here. If there is no I, we can easily add this A and B. But if there is I, it is not possible to add. Okay. So therefore, here my root 13, Dixita. My root 13 value is 3.4, like that. Okay, my 3.4 is here. So therefore, this is my complex number. Is that okay? 2 comma root 13. My root of minus 13 can be written as root of minus 1 into root of 13. Root of minus 1 is nothing but I. We don't have the value for that root of minus 1. That's why we are just taking that symbol I. I is the symbol for that root of minus 1. It is not the value. Okay. Dixita, any doubt? Any other student? Very good. Any other student, Kanna? Any other student doubt? If you have any doubt? What is the specific meaning of man lesser is that makes positive? Yeah, positive only because it is a length. Dhanushwaran, it is a length only. What is modulus? Modulus is the distance between the origin and the given complex number. Distance, your distance is always positive. Distance of this line from the origin. Yes, we are finding that distance between the DZ and the origin. That is the distance we are finding. Manavan, what is your question? Even if by means whole plane. Whole plane is organ plane. Whole plane, not whole graph. Whole graph, why you are asking whole graph? The whole entire plane is called as organ plane. If D is not a perfect square, we can represent it in a PR. Plane means, Snega, plane means it is a two-dimensional structure. Okay, if you are taking x and y axis, that is a two-dimensional structure is called it as plane, surface. Okay, so if I am taking, right, so if I am taking only one line, real number, number line. Okay, so this is called as a line. This is called as line. Okay, suppose I am taking this. This is also the real number. This is also the real number. Suppose I am considering two lines at a time. This is take it as y. This is take it as x. Okay, I will get some surface. I can form a square, form a rectangle, form a circle. I will get some surface. But here it is not possible. I can take a dot point. I can find out some point, I can make a point, I can plot a point, okay. But here I can find a surface, circle or square or rectangle, okay. So using these two set of points, this is called as a plane, okay. Yeah, graph only. Plane, it is consisting of all the set of two tuple points. So look at that, Snega. Plane means it is the representation of the points like this. Plane is a representation of the point set of two tuples. Two tuples means x comma y. 1 comma 2, 2 comma 3, 3 comma 4, 5 comma 10, 10 comma 13, 1 by 2 comma 1 by 3, 1 by 5 comma 1 by 5. 100 comma 1 by 5, 1 by 5 comma 100. Okay, the plane is consisting of the set of two tuples. What is two set of two tuples, sir? That is a pair. Look at the pair, x comma y. Okay, so therefore, plane is not a graph. You please try to understand, plane is not a graph, Snega. Okay, so look at that, this board. You look at this slide number 20, the board, blackboard. Okay, so this is consisting of all the points. here some point is there, here some point, here some point, here some point, every point we can represent like this. Okay, similarly here, this point I can represent, this point I can represent, this point. So plane, it is not a graph, it is a consisting of collection of all points. Okay, your plane is, now look at that, I am writing that. My R square is a plane. This is nothing but my set of all x comma y. My x, y belongs to R. This is the plane. Okay, in the plane, I can take a graph. Y is equal to x. This is a graph. Graph of the function. I can take, this is the graph, some collection. This line consisting of some particular points. This line consisting of some particular points. Okay, y is equal to some 2. Okay, this is called as a graph. Okay, so the plane is nothing but collection of all the points. It is not a graph. It is a collection of the set. Collection of all points. X comma in the form of x comma y. Your x and y belongs to your R. Okay. Yes, plane consists of only 2 values. Yeah, correct. Yeah, Chandru, what is your question? Chandru, please proceed. Chandru, please proceed. Yeah, how to find out the value of root 13 now? Yeah, value of root 13, we have to taking a square root that you have already studied in your lower classes. How to find out the value of root 2? How to find out the value of root 3? What is the value of root 2? 1.414. Okay, long division method, yes. 1.732, long division method. In that method, you have to find out the value of root 13. Okay, right. Some student is asking some doubts. Sir, how to represent? Yeah, now ask your doubts. I am ready to answer for all of your questions. Yeah. Come on. Okay, so this is my x, this is my y, this is imaginary axis, this is real axis. Okay, right. So here I'm taking this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Similarly, here I'm going to take it as this is take it as 1, this is take it as 2, this is take it as 3, this is take it as 4. Yeah, now ask your questions one by one. Yeah, yeah, you please don't worry, Abhinaya, I will solve the question definitely. Without solving, I never close this session, don't worry. Okay, I will finish this and come back. How to calculate modulus of root 3 plus root 7? Kanna, you please ask complex number related questions. How to find out modulus of root 3 plus root 7? You just give a complex number. This is root 3 plus root 7. Your root 3 is 1.732. Your root 7 is, okay, so this is nearly 2.4 like that. Okay, you just add these two. You just add these 2.4 and 1.7. Okay, what we are getting? So this is 3 point something like that. Okay. You can take it as 2.7 as. So what is the answer for this when you're adding these two? This is 3.2, this is 1. Okay, so this is 3.1. My 3.1 is here, plus I0. Okay, my 3.1 is here. Right, my in imaginary axis, that is 0. So therefore, this is my Z. Are you okay? This is root 3 plus root 7 comma 0. Are you okay, Tambi? Any other doubt? If A is negative, in A plus IB. Yeah, come to this side. What is that minus 2? Suppose I am taking minus 2. My z is minus 2 plus 3i. What is the answer? Here my x is minus 2, y is 3. This is my z. Minus 2 comma 3. Are you okay? Any other? Modulus of z is, yeah, 3.1. Chandru, correct. Because this is the distance from the origin. What is the distance? From the origin, what is the distance? 3.1 only. Your R modulus is 3.1 only. Okay. Any other doubt? 1.2 plus root 41. The same thing. Look at that. If you take 1.2 plus root 41, why? You have to find out the root 41 value first. My root 41 value may be 6.4. Okay. 1.2 plus 6.4. Okay, add these two, that is 7.8. Your 7.8 is nothing but here. Your 7.8, your imaginary part is 0. Imaginary part is not given means it is 0. Yeah, here also some xy values are there. Here my y value is 0, that's all. Here also in every point we have x coordinate and y coordinate. If y coordinate, that means the imaginary part is not given means you take it as 0. That is my y coordinate. In every point we have x coordinate, y coordinate. If imaginary point is not given, you can take it as your y coordinate as a 0. Yeah, that is, I have already told that it is a long division method. Okay, long division method you have already studied in lower classes. How to find out the root 2 value, root 3 value, root 5 value. Okay. Yeah, modulus is root 3. Okay. In some graph also we can see x comma y values, right, sir? Snega, please try to understand. Not in some graph. What you are meaning in some graph? Yeah. Look at that, your 3.1 means this point is 3.1 comma 0. Your y is there, this is your y, this is your x, your y is 0. So every point, every complex number having some real values and imaginary values. If imaginary value is not given means you have to take it as 0. Don't mean that it is only x, not only y. Okay, a plane is a graph only, yeah. Okay. Dekana. Ipana son number. Root 3 plus root 7 comma 0. What is your root 3 plus root 7? That is 3.132 plus I0. This is the modulus. This length is the modulus. 3.1 is the answer. Okay, this 3.1 is the answer. This is a modulus. Okay, right. So please, first of all, listen the class and then ask your doubts. Okay. Right. Now, what is your modulus? You please, all of you, take a notes. The modulus. Let z equal to a plus ib. Okay, then modulus of z. Is defined as, my modulus of z is nothing but root of a square plus b square. Okay, and this is my z, this is my complex number a comma b, this is my a, this is my b. Based on this, this is my modulus of z. Your modulus of z is nothing but the length between that origin and the complex number OZ. Okay, this should be positive only, right? Okay, now come to that. The next one is the conjugate of z. The conjugate of Is that is Z bar denoted by Z bar. This is nothing but A minus IB. Your conjugate is nothing but conjugate of Z is this is. You can take here. My conjugate of Z is Z bar. A comma minus B is my conjugate. Are you okay? It is look like a mirror value. My conjugate of Z is Z bar, that is nothing but A comma minus B, that is A comma A minus IB. Okay, so therefore this is my conjugate. What is the modulus of this conjugate, modulus of this conjugate value? So this is also root of this A square plus this minus B square. This is also the same, root of A square plus B square. So which implies, what is that? Your modulus of Z and modulus of Z conjugate, both are same. Okay, that means from the origin, the is a complex number and its conjugate distance, both are same. Okay. Suppose I am taking as an example, let my Z is equal to 2 plus 3i. So then what is my modulus? My modulus is root over 2 square plus 3 square. Okay. So what is the answer? 2 square 4, 3 square 9, therefore root 13. So how to find out the root 13 value, sir? You have to go for that long division method. Okay, finding the root value, square root value. Otherwise, you can keep it as root 13 as root 13. Don't worry about that. Simplifying. So now take it as, suppose I am taking as only 5. My Z is only 5. Okay, what is my modulus of Z? My modulus of Z is nothing but 5 square plus 0 square. So that is root 5. That is 5 alone. Okay. My Z is equal to 5 is also a complex number. Please try to note that. Suppose I am taking my Z is equal to minus 5 minus 3i. How to represent this minus 5 minus 3i? Look at that. This is my minus 5. This is my minus 3. So, okay, my point is here. My complex number is here only. Is that minus 5 comma minus 3. This is my complex number. From the origin, what is the distance? Okay, so that is nothing but modulus. Modulus of Z is equal to root over minus 5 square plus minus 3 square. Don't take it I, you take it as only A and B. Don't take it as I. So therefore, this is 25, this is 9. So therefore, root 34 is the distance. Okay. Are you clear about the modulus? Any doubt? Yeah, very good. Yeah, Z bar denotes conjugate. Modulus is the distance. Are you okay? Yeah, look at that. This is my this is my complex number. Please note that this is my complex number. Okay, your conjugate means you take a mirror image, the mirror image of this. You can keep the your x value as it is a, you can take it as this opposite value minus b. Okay, so this is your conjugate mirror value. Okay, so this is a graph. Look at that. This is my conjugate of this z. Suppose if you take my complex number z is equal to a plus ib, then your conjugate is a minus ib is the conjugate. Okay, and your modulus is same, right? Okay, now look at that. How to find out the multiplicative inverse? Multiplicative inverse of a non-zero complex number. Multiplicative inverse of a non-zero complex number. So we have already discussed what is our multiplicative inverse. My multiplicative inverse is nothing but z inverse. My z inverse is nothing but 1 by z. My 1 by z is nothing but a plus ib. Take a conjugate, a minus ib by a minus ib, multiply. So what is the answer we are getting? A minus ib divided by, this is nothing but a square. Here ib the whole square. Your ib the whole square means I square b square, but I square is minus 1. I will get it as a square plus b square. Okay, so therefore this is a divided by a square plus b square plus I into minus b divided by a square plus b square. This is we have already discussed. Are you okay? This is we have already discussed. Are you okay? Are you remember that? Yeah, why non-zero? You please tell me, Chandru. Why it is non-zero? Why it is non-zero? This is conjugate, kana? Dear student, this is conjugate number. Your a is it equal to a plus ib is the original complex number, and this is the conjugate. This point is the conjugate. Are you okay? Chandru, why we are taking non-zero number? Because if your complex number z is 0, you will get 0 plus 0 here. Here also 0, here also 0. That is my complex number, 0 complex number. Okay, so 1 by 0, it is undefined. Multiplicative inverse undefined for a complex 0 complex number. Okay, yeah, very good. So therefore, non-zero number only, we can find the complex complex multiplicative inverse. For every non-zero complex number, we can find the multiplicative inverse. Okay, right. This is we have already known. It is we have already discussed. Okay, right. Now I am going to apply that my z inverse or 1 by z equal to what is that? This is a minus b divided by a square plus b square. Look at that. This a minus b is nothing but conjugate of z. This a square plus b square is nothing but modulus of z the square. Are you okay? See that previous slide? What is my a conjugate? My conjugate is a minus ib. If a is a plus b is the complex number, my conjugate is a minus ib. What is the modulus? Modulus of z is root over a square plus b square. But here only a square plus b square, therefore modulus of z the whole square. So therefore, you just cross multiply. Okay, modulus of z square is equal to z into z bar. This is the first result. Okay, you can use this also. You can easily find out your, this is one result. This is multiplicative inverse. Your multiplicative inverse is nothing but z bar by modulus of z square. If you cross multiply, you will get this result also. Z into z bar, the complex number and the multiplication of its conjugate, that is gives as the modulus of z the whole square, that is the length square from the origin. Okay, right. So we have to discuss some more results for any two complex numbers. First result is modulus of z plus 1 z plus 2 is equal to modulus of z 1 plus modulus of z 2. Okay, second result is modulus of z 1 by z 2 equal to modulus of z 1 by modulus of z 2. My z 2 is not equal to 0. Modulus of z 2 is not equal to 0. And third result is z 1 into z 2 conjugate equal to z 1 bar into z 2 bar. So look at that, your z 1 into z 2 means this is nothing but another conjugate number. Suppose look at that, I am taking z 1 is equal to 1 plus I. Okay, my z 2 is equal to some 2 plus I. You just multiply z 1 and z 2. Okay, how to multiply? You can multiply, apply the formula, or you can directly multiply 2 plus I plus multiply by I, that is 2i, I into I, that is I square. Okay, so therefore this is 2, here your I square is minus 1, 2 plus I plus 2i minus 1. So therefore this is nothing but 1 plus 3i. Your z1 into z2 is another complex number. 1 plus 3i. What is the conjugate of this 1 plus 3i? This is 1, this is 3. This is my z. 1 comma 3. Okay, what is the conjugate of here? This is 1 comma, my conjugate is 1 comma minus 3. Okay. So this is my 1 comma minus 3. Okay, though this is my conjugate. So this z is nothing but z1 into z2 bar. I'm getting another complex number. Take a conjugate for this complex number, that is equal to take a complex conjugate for individually. You take a conjugate for this, take a conjugate for this, and multiply these two, you will get the same answer. That is a property. Is it okay? Kana, this is modulus of z bar. Modulus of z bar is nothing but from the origin to the distance between the origin to the complex number. This is my modulus of z bar. This modulus of z bar, this modulus of z, both are same. Yeah, I will show. I will show you all the slides. Yes, what is my first result? What is my first result? If you add these two complex numbers and take a modulus. If you're adding these two complex numbers, that is again a complex number. Sir, I'm going to add the two complex numbers, sir. Yeah, you please add it. Again, you will get a complex number. And we can find out the modulus for that complex number. That is equal to, you separately find the modulus and then add, both are equal. Here, after adding, I will get one complex number. Okay, I am just finding the modulus. Here, I'm finding the modulus for separately. And then add, I'm getting the same answer. Okay, modulus value, both are same. Here also similarly, here I'm dividing two complex number, z1 by z2. How to divide, sir? Your dividing is nothing but z1 into 1 by z2. Your 1 by z2 is nothing but the multiplicative inverse of z2. Okay, 1 by z2 is nothing but the multiplicative inverse of z2. Find out the multiplicative inverse of z2.
okay,
and that is your 1 by z2, and multiply z1 and 1 by z2, you will get that z1 by z2, and again you will get a complex number. Find the modulus. Okay, that modulus is equal to finding the modulus for separately z1 and z2 and divide that, both giving the same answer. Okay, right. So here, what is my conjugate? Z1 into z2 bar. This is 1 plus 3i. This is, I am getting 1 minus 3i. Okay, similarly, come to the right hand side. What is my z1 bar? My z1, this is my z1. My z1 bar is 1 minus i. My z2 bar, that is conjugate. Bar means conjugate. My conjugate of the second number is 2 minus i. Okay, now multiply these two. What is the answer? Z1 bar, z2 bar equal to 1 minus i, 2 minus i. Multiplication. So multiply this one, 1 into 2, 2, 1 into i. This is minus 2i. This is minus into minus plus I square. Okay, this is my I square is minus 1. So 2 minus 1, it is nothing but 1. Minus I, minus 2i, minus 3i. So look at this. This is also 1 minus 3i. This is also 1 minus 3i. Both are same. Are you okay? My z1 into z2 the whole bar equal to z1 bar into z2 bar. Bar means this is nothing but conjugate. Are you clear? Yes, look at that. Therefore, my z1 into z2 bar is equal to z1 bar into z2 bar. Okay? Right. My fourth one is z1 plus r minus z2 the whole bar equal to z1 bar plus r minus z2 bar. Fifth one is z1 by z2 the whole conjugate equal to z1 conjugate divided by z2 conjugate. Here my z2 is not equal to z2 bar is not equal to 0, because if this complex number is 0, then this is undefined. Okay, right. Some student asking some doubt in our previous class. I think the question number is I power minus 40. Am I correct? This is a question you have asked. Yes, some student asking some doubt in that I power minus 40. Am I correct? That is a question. The question is right. Yes. Okay. So now look at that. We have a result. I power 4k. 4k means multiple of 4. If the power is a multiple of 4, okay, so then the answer must be 1. If the power is the multiple of 4k plus 1, okay, what is my answer? My answer is I. My power is the 4k plus 2, multiple of 4k plus 2, my answer is minus 1. And 4k plus 3 means my answer is minus I. This is we have already discussed. Okay, this is I am going to write it as I power 40. 1 by I power 40. I power minus 40 can be written as 1 by I power 40. This 40 is a multiple of 4 or not? This 40 is a multiple of 4. Multiple of 4 means the answer is 1. So the answer is 1. That's all. Problem over. Are you okay? Are you clear? Okay, what is 1 plus y? Yeah. Right. So some student is asking the second one. Yeah, this is the second one. Is it one by is it two? Take it as is that one is 1 plus I, is that 2 is some 2 plus I. Okay, what is the second one? My is that 1 by is that 2, the whole modulus. Is that 1 is equal to 1 plus I, my is that 2 is equal to 2 plus I. Okay, is that 1 divided by is that 2. How to find out is that 1 divided by is that 2? My is that 1 into 1 by is that 2. So you have to find out the multiplicative inverse. What is my 1 by is that 2? Okay, my 1 by is that 2 is that 2 bar divided by modulus of is that 2 the whole square. Look at that. My 1 by is that multiplicative inverse formula is z bar divided by modulus of z square. This is a multiplicative inverse formula using modulus. 1 by z is equal to z bar by modulus z the whole square. Here z2 means z2 bar by modulus of z the whole square. My z2 is z2 bar conjugate 2 minus I divided by the modulus of this is 2 square plus 1 square. That is root 5. So therefore, this is nothing but my 1 plus I into my 1 by z2 is nothing but 2 by root 5 minus I by root 5. Just multiply by 1, 2 by root 5 minus I by root 5. Okay. Right. And this is multiplied by I. So this is 2 by root 5 I. This is I into I square. I square is minus 1. Already minus is there. Therefore, plus 1. 1 by root 5. Okay. So, therefore, this is 2 by root 5. This is 1 by root 5. Totally 3 by root 5. And this is 2 by root 5 minus 1 by root 5. This is nothing but 1 by root 5. Okay. Take a magnitude for this. Magnitude for that is modulus. My modulus of z1 by z2 is, this is 3 by root 5 the whole square plus 1 by root 5 the whole square. What is the answer? This is 9 by 5. This is 1 by 5. Totally 10 by 5. 10 by 5 is nothing but 2. That is root 2. Are you okay? The left hand side is root 2. What about my right hand side? My right hand side is nothing but magnitude of z1 by magnitude of z2. What is my magnitude of z1? This is root 2. This is my so after that the slide is not coming, I think. Okay, you give an example that is magnitude of z1 by z2 is nothing but you take some numbers z1 and z2 complex numbers, divide z1 and z2. How to divide? That is multiplication of z1 and into 1 by z2, like that we have done. Okay, finally you will get a complex number. After getting a complex number, you take a magnitude, that is modulus. So this is after dividing, take a modulus. Here, taking modulus both separately and then divide. Both will be equal only. Okay. So if you want, we will discuss, because here the next slide is not coming. So therefore, we'll discuss more problems in our next class. Okay. You take copy up to this. I will show the slides. This is our first slide. This is our second. third one, fourth one, five. So the other slides are not coming, I think. I don't know why. So when I'm clicking the plus symbol, I'm getting the new slide. Are you okay? But I have wrote the 25th slide. That 25th slide is not coming. Yeah, yeah, please. This is your first slide. Are you okay? Thank you, Monishwar. We will discuss more problems in your next class. Okay. What is A and what is A? A complement. A dash means, look at that, students. This is complement. Complement of A. This is difference. Difference operation. Difference of A and B. These two not included in your syllabus. Deleted. These two are deleted. These two are not included. Deleted syllabus. Are you okay? Right. Okay, my dear students. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you. Thank you all. Chapter 1 is test. This number of slides only available. Yes, thank you. We will discuss remaining problems in our next class. Okay, thank you all. Thank you so much.